In this video, we're going to install Atom and configure it for use with the Python programming language. Okay, to install Atom, the first thing we need to do is to retrieve the install. So open your web browser of choice, I'm using Chrome, and navigate to atom.io. Here's what their webpage looks like. Now, if you're running a Windows 64-bit machine, straight away you can just click the download button. As you'll see here, this is for a 64-bit operating system of Windows 7 or later. However, if you're on a different platform, you'll need to select this option down here for other platforms. That will take you to GitHub, where, when we scroll down, we can see the various files for the installation process. Here we have a 32-bit setup, the 64-bit setup for Windows. We have our Mac zip and our Windows zip if you prefer zips as well. So I'm going to go back to their webpage and select their primary download. Most people will be able to do this. Once you open the file you've just downloaded, you'll receive a similar screen to this. Please note that this installation process does not give you any options. It simply installs where it needs to, and will ultimately place an icon on the desktop like so. Alright, the installation is now complete and Atom is installed on our system. However, it is not yet ready for us to use with Python. There are still a few more steps that we need to take. Register the default Atom URI handler. Just select no. The next step that we need to do to get Atom working with Python is to install a few packages. Okay, I'm just going to make the window a little bit larger. There we go. So the packages that we want to get are Python. We'll be provided with a list of all of the valid Python packages. The first package that we want is Atom Python Run. So if we click install, it'll begin that process and it will take a moment or two to complete. The next package that we want is called autocomplete Python. We could have scrolled down through the list to find it, but it's easier just to type the name. Here it is here, autocomplete Python. If we install that, this will allow the editor to do autocompletion for us based upon the Python programming language, as well as syntax highlighting and such. Do we want to add kite? No. I don't personally use it, and it's certainly not needed. Once that's complete, we can check that it has worked by coming across to the packages option on the left-hand side, and it will tell us what packages are currently installed. So we have Atom Python Run, which allows us to press F5 when we have our application open in the editor to run that program. And we have the autocomplete, which is our syntax highlighting and such. All right, let's just test these out to make sure that everything is working properly. I'll just close these other tabs. File, new file. Now, none of the syntax highlighting or extra functionality will work until we first save the file as a .py file extension. So the first thing I'm going to do is say file, save as, I'll just go to my C drive, into my temp folder for want of a better location, and say test.py, py being the Python file extension. Save. Okay, so I now have my brand new Python file, and I should have syntax highlighting. So if we do the traditional hello world, print, hello world. Okay, Nothing terribly exciting or complicated there. Print hello world, our syntax highlighting is working. Now if I save the file, Control S on the keyboard under Windows, and press the F5 key on my keyboard, it should run the program by opening up a command prompt and activating it. So there we go, it's print hello world to the screen, exactly as we expected it would. So those two packages are installed properly and are working. And that is all there is to it. Atom is now installed and set up, working, ready for Python. Thank you. If you found this video helpful, then click the subscribe button below this video and leave a comment.